This video is brought to you by Unseasoned. Go subscribe to Unseasoned and check out their exclusive and insightful interviews with females on dating, relationships, and preferences. They get straight to the point and ask the questions that's on every guy's mind. I'll also leave a link in the description.
I feel like I need that like age gap because guys are definitely very immature.
Linger a little bit. You take a little sip of your drink, giggle, look away.
And he's like, yeah, reservation for two. And the woman looks up his name. She's like, sir, that reservation's for tomorrow.
Anfernee Dionne Hardaway, aka Penny Hardaway, born July 18, 1971. Today's feature is arguably the most popular of all time, along with being one of the most documented players covered in the YouTube era. With that said, this won't be your typical coverage where we talk about the obvious reasons his growth was stunted. Instead, I'd like to make the argument for three other reasons I think no one ever talks about. Today's generation may know Penny as the smooth-talking, youth-relatable head coach of one of the most popular schools in amateur athletics today. But some of us actually remember the player, the commercials, him defeating a Michael Jordan-led Bulls team in the playoffs, forming one of the best duos in history that historically didn't live up to their billing, and of course, the injuries, the fall-off and letdown his career turned out to be. Had all gone the way things were expected to go, he'd absolutely be in the Naismith Basketball Hall of Fame by now, instead of having to settle for just the Orlando Magic Hall of Fame, for whatever that's worth. Salute to all my people in the growth community that voted for this feature. I was looking forward to bringing you another forgotten gem like Corey Alexander or Jason Gardner, but was excited to tackle the people's choice, Penny's story. Salute to y'all. Let's get into it. It's your boy JC Stunted Growth. Let's get it, man. Stunt number one, Magic Load. Many people look at Penny's career and they point to the obvious injuries that took his career hostage. And they definitely have that argument won. But why? What caused those actual knee injuries early into his promising career? Hardaway is from Memphis, Tennessee, where he was raised predominantly by his grandmother that gave him the nickname Penny from the popular phrase, Pretty Penny. Hardaway has always been ahead of his time, and by his senior year in high school, was one of the best and most sought after high school players ever, averaging 36.6 points a game, 10 rebounds, 6 assists, 3.9 steals, and 2.8 blocks, and winning the Parade Magazine National Player of the Year award. He decided to attend his hometown, Memphis State University, now known as University of Memphis. Before he actually got to suit up for the team, he was academically ineligible his first year, involved in a shooting where he took one to the foot and robbed at gunpoint. Penny would get it together though, and stepped on the floor as a redshirt freshman and was everything he was paraded to be, leading his team to a 25-11 record and losing in the Midwest Regional Final, 88-57, to Cincinnati. He averaged 17.4 points a game, 7 rebounds, and 5.5 assists that season, being named an All-American. In his second playing season, he was even more impressive, upping his averages in scoring, rebounds, and assists, though this time his team lost in the first round of the tournament. That summer, he was asked to do a movie, Blue Chips, and was the first real encounter to Shaquille O'Neal, who was amazed by Penny's skills, size, and match with his own game, and urged the team to try and get Penny in the draft, saying this kid is gonna be the next big superstar. For the most part, Shaq was right about that, and for the first four seasons of his career, Penny, the third overall pick by Golden State, who was traded to the Magic for Chris Webber, was all that. Now to my argument's point. A lot of the reason Penny was able to do what he was able to do was because of the presence of Shaq. In Penny's rookie year, Shaquille was already a star in the league after just one season as the reigning Rookie of the Year. In his second season, Penny's rookie year, he was even more dominant and a clear-cut superstar in the league with just as big a personality. He was also the first rookie to be named an All-Star since Michael Jordan in 1985. I don't want to say it was easy playing alongside a player like O'Neal, but in all actuality, it's the best thing a point guard can ask for, and Penny flourished not having to assume the number one player role. He could be groomed as the sidekick for as long as Shaq garnered the spotlight like he did. And not only did this make the game easier for him, it made it easier on his body as well, being able to take plays off while Shaq pounded his opponents down low. Shaquille would eventually leave the Magic in the 96-97 season, the very season that was Penny's last as being this dominant point guard in the mold or cross between Magic and Jordan, whom he defeated 4-2 in Jordan's first playoffs in his return to the game after retirement. By this point, Hardaway was an all-star, bona fide commercial star, and surefire future Hall of Fame point guard. That 96-97 season, his first without Shaq, Penny led a team whose next best player was Nick Anderson to the playoffs. They lost in the first round to the Miami Heat. The load and expectations must have been a lot to deal with for Penny, and he began having, as he called it, weird knee pains out of nowhere. Because he didn't suffer a gruesome, obvious injury like Derrick Rose, people began to doubt his injury like he was faking it and pressured him to return to the game, which in hindsight is what caused further damage and eventually the rest of his superstar career. Not having the big guy Shaq at his side for those times and the pressure to lead a team led Penny to his first growth stunt, taking on too much load for the Magic. Stunt number two, reliance. Another huge stunt that no one ever talks about when it pertains to Penny Hardaway's struggles with injury is his over-reliance on his physical abilities and not developing a consistent jumper he could trust to essentially take some plays off. Penny has never really been a good shooter, not in college and certainly not in the NBA. At 6'7", smooth but quick handles, speed and crazy athleticism, Hardaway didn't always need to develop an outside shot he could use instead of having to put so much pressure on driving it every time to score or make a play for others. Damian Lillard is probably my favorite player ever that found that perfect balance between shooting and driving. Harden shoots too much. Rose didn't shoot it enough. Curry shoots too much, although he's auto. But Dame has mastered it, to the point you can never predict what he's gonna do. A player a lot of you young guys should study like it's finals. The reason he's been able to stay pretty much healthy throughout his career is because he doesn't need to drive it every time. Having the range to pull it three steps past half court consistently saves so much pounding and pressure on your body that you can reduce the wear and tear and have a longer career. Hardaway didn't achieve that knowledge, and some of it was the era he was in, where star players didn't really rely on that. Driving, slashing, and being athletic slash strong was in at the time, and it hurt Hardaway and made him only last 4 years as a star in the league. For his NBA career, he shot 31% from three, had a few seasons under 30% while only attempting two a game. Young guys understand how to make the game easy. Learn and perfect how to shoot the ball. It'll help you stay fresh and ultimately lengthen your career. Stunt number three, heart over smarts. Penny Hardaway's final stunt came unfortunately because what made him such a killer on the court ultimately is what cost him a chance at regaining his career. He had too much heart. That, along with the era of play through it or you're soft, and pressure from the world around him to continue being the dominant player he was, to not let the injuries derail him from the expectations of being the next great and showing the Magic they made the right choice in choosing him over Shaq, which was reportedly why O'Neal didn't sign back with the team. Penny didn't want the team to pay Shaq like the best player and save that money for him, allegedly. I remember Shaq saying something a while back that astonished me and made so much sense to my young mind. When asked what it was like to play with three superstar guards like he had in Penny, D-Wade, and Kobe, Shaq said something to the effect that one wasn't ready, another wanted it too bad, and the other was just right, referring to Penny as the one that just wasn't ready for it. I think he meant physically, Penny's body just wasn't ready for the load a superstar carries, and his attitude and ego wasn't as well, in him devaluing Shaq as the leader of the team and understanding how important Shaq's role to his success was. But that's second to my point of how Hardaway let the heart he had make him stay on the floor to prove he was ready and came back too early in the 97-98 season. Some say to play in the All-Star game and continue his streak of 4 in a row. After the All-Star game, he played in one game and missed the remainder of the season. He's since endured another 4 surgeries on his left knee, and those gradually deteriorated his explosive, athletic abilities. In 19 games, he averaged 16.4 points, 4 rebounds, 3.6 assists, and 1.5 steals. It'd be the last of the star player we'd see. He'd play one more season for Orlando, but it was clear he wasn't the future and was involved in a sign and trade before the start of the 99-2000 NBA season to the Phoenix Suns, where he played 4 seasons before being traded to the Knicks in January of 04. He played there a few years, retire in 06, come out of retirement, and play in the 07-08 season with the Heat, where he was a shell of himself ever since leaving Orlando. He would begin his coaching career in 2015 to presently the head coach of his alma mater Memphis, one of the leading programs in the country as far as talent and popularity. All in all, Penny had a great ride, man. Some consider him a disappointment or a bust, which I don't think so at all. Had injury not hamper him, he'd definitely be one of the greats. But for these reasons, his growth was stunted. Salute to him, much respect. Thank you guys for this request. It's your boy JC, Stunted Growth, and I'm out.